स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्दगुरुं भजे स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं.
Understand this sutra, understand this technique, it can liberate you from depression forever, because I worked with this technique. I am telling you, if you just chase suffering, I always tell people, people come and tell me, Swamiji, I am suffocated, suffering by sexual thoughts, what should I do? I tell them, sit in this corner for next half an hour, meditate on sex. In 5 minutes they open their eyes and say, I am not able to concentrate on it, Swamiji. My mind is going somewhere here and there. I tell them, what are you talking? You come and tell me that you are suffering with the thoughts and I am telling you meditate on it. You are saying that you are not able to meditate on it. Your mind is going here and there. Then what it means? The struggle keeps the struggle alive. Understand? Struggling keeps the struggle alive. This is one of the important click. Struggling keeps the struggle alive. If you are suffering with sadness and depression, means everyone, who else? Except an enlightened person, everyone will be struggling. Enlightened person is not struggling because he is not struggling, that's all. He knows it is a cloud. If it comes, it comes. If it goes, it goes. And there is no cloud. When you are clear, the cloud is going to move away. Suddenly you will be raised to a place above the cloud, where cloud cannot hide your vision. Understand? Whenever the cloud is crossing between you and the sun, if you just remember that cloud is going to move and you are going to see the sun, you will suddenly be lifted above the cloud. You will be above the cloud and there will be never a cloud hiding you. The click the cloud is going to move will elevate you beyond the clouds and will take you above the clouds. One important thing you need to realize, continuously the word which you are uttering creates struggle. If you decide, I am going to be in suffering, it's okay. Nothing can be done. What to do? There is nobody to save. There is no way to save. I am suffering. What can be done now? Just sit with that for 10 days, morning till night. I tell you, the suffering or the sadness which you are carrying in your bio memory, it will not have the suppression and it will leave your system. Now, as on now, struggle keeps that bio memory, depth of sadness, depression inside you by suppressing it. If you decide not to struggle, suddenly you will see it will be released to the air. It will leave your system. It will just leave the system. 10 days visualize that you are filled with suffering, sadness. Within 10 days, you will see the sadness will, suddenly the struggling with the sadness will disappear. Now what to do? Yes, I am with sadness. Now what can be done? Nothing can be done. Suddenly, the sadness will become peace, silence. You will cross the depth of sadness and it will become peace. And continue to carry that peace. Without fighting, the peace will explode into bliss. That is the only way you can achieve the bliss continuously. Not in any other way. Please understand, not in any other way. You will not be able to visualize or hold on to happiness continuously. Because your mind is not trained or conditioned to remember, hold on to joy. It is not conditioned or remembered. Planned, it is not programmed to hold on to joy continuously. Try to hold on to happiness for half an hour. No, Swamiji, what to do? Sadness comes back. That's why I'm telling, then try to hold on for sadness. The quality of sadness will become peace. Because I worked with this technique before my own enlightenment, I'm telling you, this is a very powerful technique to go to the depth of your being. Then the peace you will see explodes into bliss. But the moment the depth of the bio-memory of depression which you are carrying leaves your system, see, when you stop the struggling with your sadness, every moment you are in sadness will release the sadness memory from your system. The memory which is inside your system will be released. 10 days is maximum. I tell you, even if you are in worst depression, you are not in that level of whatever depression you may be. 10 days is more than enough to release the bio memory if you just stop fighting with it. If you just stop fighting with it. And the moment it goes to the peace, the depth of the peace, you will see, when peace sinks inside your system, it explodes as bliss. Then you don't have to even practice this technique. You don't have to practice this technique. You will see constantly you are feeling that your substance, bones, flesh, blood, saturated with a bliss. I tell you exactly how enlightenment feels. It feels like you are empty body, filled with bliss, and anything which comes from outside and touches your body is bliss. Whether it is some scene or some music or some sound, any scene, any smell, any food and any touch is bliss, eating the bliss. Your body becomes like a bliss bag, like a bean bag, bliss bag. Bliss bag is hit by bliss file. Then what will come out? Bliss oozing out. That is what exactly enlightenment feels. Understand? Exactly the same thing will happen in you. The moment you stop fighting and go through with your sadness, you come to terms with your sadness. You come to terms with your sadness. As on now, because you already created vengeance and arrogance against the sadness, you don't see face to face. That is why problem never gets settled. She is always in the kitchen, you are always in the living room. Never you sit and talk. So things never comes to terms. With this meditating on sadness, you will come to the same table. If you sit in the same table and start talking, you have to settle. You have to come to terms. Because both of you have to live in one body, one home. Understand? It can straight away relieve you from the struggle with the depression and relieve the bio memory, the depression which you are carrying, above all, will totally put you in peace, the silence. Sadness, when you are not trying to convert it to happiness or fighting with it, will lead you to deep peace. Ramakrishna gives a wonderful technique. Cry in front of God, praying. You will see the whole depression and the mind leaves you. And I have seen, it's happening. It happens. Now I'm not asking you to cry, but intensely meditate. If the tears come, let it come. You will see the depression leaves you, silence, peace lands on you, and you settle inside the peace. Settling with the peace will automatically explode into bliss. This is the understanding of the same sutra as Nitya Sutra, means practicing whole day.